chapters 18 through 21 of Judges, American Standard Version. This is a LibriVox recording. All LibriVox recordings are in the public domain. For more information and to find out how you can volunteer, please visit LibriVox.org. Recording by Sam Stinson. Chapter 18. In those days there was no king in Israel, and in those days the tribe of the Danites sought them an inheritance to dwell in, for unto that day their inheritance had not fallen unto them among the tribes of Israel. And the children of Dan sent of their family 5 men from their whole number, men of valor from Zorah and from Eshtaol, to spy out the land, and to search it. And they said unto them, Go, search the land. And they came to the hill country of Ephraim, unto the house of Micah, and lodged there. When they were by the house of Micah, they knew the voice of the young man the Levite. And they turned aside thither, and said unto him, Who brought thee hither? And what doest thou in this place? And what hast thou here? And he said unto them, Thus and thus hath Micah dealt with me, and he hath hired me, and I am become his priest. And they said unto him, Ask counsel, we pray thee, of God, that we may know whether our way which we go shall be prosperous. And the priest said unto them, Go in peace, before Jehovah is your way wherein ye go. Then the 5 men departed, and came to Laish, and saw the people that were therein, how they dwelt in security, after the manner of the Sidonians, quiet and secure, for there was none in the land possessing authority that might put them to shame in anything, and they were far from the Sidonians, and had no dealings with any man. And they came unto their brethren, to Zorah and Eshtaol, and their brethren said unto them, What say ye? And they said, Arise, and let us go up against them, for we have seen the land, and behold, it is very good. And are ye still? Be not slothful to go and to enter in to possess the land. When ye go, ye shall come unto a people secure, and the land is large, for God hath given it into your hand, a place where there is no want of anything that is in the earth. And there set forth from thence of the family of the Danites, out of Zorah and out of Eshtaol, 600 men girt with weapons of war. And they went up and encamped in Kirith-Jearim in Judah, wherefore they called that place Mahaneh Dan unto this day. Behold, it is behind Kirith-Jearim. And they passed thence unto the hill country of Ephraim, and came unto the house of Micah. Then answered the 5 men that went to spy out the country of Laish, and said unto their brethren, Do ye know that there is in these houses an ephod, and teraphim, and a graven image, and a molten image? Now therefore consider what ye have to do. And they turned aside thither, and came to the house of the young man the Levite, even unto the house of Micah, and asked him of his welfare. And the 600 men girt with their weapons of war, who were of the children of Dan, stood by the entrance of the gate. And the 5 men that went to spy out the land went up, and came in thither, and took the graven image, and the ephod, and the teraphim, and the molten image. And the priest stood by the entrance of the gate with the 600 men girt with weapons of war. And when these went into Micah's house, and fetched the graven image, the ephod, and the teraphim, and the molten image, the priest said unto them, What do ye? And they said unto him, Hold thy peace, lay thy hand upon thy mouth, and go with us, and be to us a father and a priest. Is it better for thee to be priest unto the house of one man, or to be priest unto a tribe and a family in Israel? And the priest's heart was glad, and he took the ephod and the teraphim and the graven image, and went in the midst of the people. So they turned and departed, and put the little ones and the cattle and the goods before them. When they were a good way from the house of Micah, the men that were in the houses near to Micah's house were gathered together, and overtook the children of Dan. And they cried unto the children of Dan, and they turned their faces, and said unto Micah, What aileth thee, that thou comest with such a company? And he said, Ye have taken away my gods, which I made, and the priest, and are gone away, and what have I more? And how then say ye unto me, What aileth thee? And the children of Dan said unto him, Let not thy voice be heard among us, lest angry fellows fall upon you, and thou lose thy life, with the lives of thy household. And the children of Dan went their way, and when Micah saw that they were too strong for him, he turned and went back unto his house. And they took that which Micah had made, and the priest whom he had, and came unto Laish, unto a people quiet and secure, and smote them with the edge of the sword, and they burnt the city with fire. And there was no deliverer, because it was far from Sidon, and they had no dealings with any man, and it was in the valley that lieth by Beth-Rehob. And they built the city, and dwelt therein. And they called the name of the city Dan, after the name of Dan their father, who was born unto Israel. Howbeit the name of the city was Laish at the first. And the children of Dan set up for themselves the graven image, and Jonathan the son of Gershom, the son of Moses, he and his sons were priests to the tribe of the Danites until the day of the captivity of the land. So they set them up Micah's graven image, which he made, all the time that the house of God was in Shiloh. End of chapter 18. Chapter 19. And it came to pass in those days, when there was no king in Israel, that there was a certain Levite sojourning on the farther side of the hill country of Ephraim, who took to him a concubine out of Bethlehem, Judah. And his concubine played the harlot against him, and went away from him unto her father's house, to Bethlehem, Judah, and was there the space of 4 months. And her husband arose and went after her, to speak kindly unto her, to bring her again, having his servant with him, and a couple of asses. And she brought him into her father's house. And when the father of the damsel saw him, he rejoiced to meet him. And his father-in-law, the damsel's father, retained him, and he abode with him 3 days. So they did eat, and drink, and lodged there. And it came to pass on the fourth day, that they arose early in the morning, and he rose up to depart. And the damsel's father said unto his son-in-law, Strengthen thy heart with a morsel of bread, and afterward ye shall go your way. So they sat down, and did eat and drink, both of them together. And the damsel's father said unto the man, Be pleased, I pray thee, to tarry all night, and let thy heart be merry. And the man rose up to depart, but his father-in-law urged him, and he lodged there again. And he arose early in the morning on the fifth day to depart. And the damsel's father said, Strengthen thy heart, I pray thee, and tarry ye until the day declineth. And they did eat, both of them. And when the man rose up to depart, he and his concubine, and his servant, his father-in-law, the damsel's father, said unto him, Behold, now the day draweth toward evening. I pray you tarry all night. Behold, the day groweth to an end. Lodge here, that thy heart may be merry. And tomorrow get you early on your way, that thou mayest go home. But the man would not tarry that night. But he rose up and departed, and came over against Jebus, the same is Jerusalem. And there were with him a couple of asses saddled. His concubine also was with him. When they were by Jebus, the day was far spent. And the servant said unto his master, Come, I pray thee, and let us turn aside into this city of the Jebusites, and lodge in it. And his master said unto him, We will not turn aside into the city of a foreigner. That is not of the children of Israel, but we will pass over to Gibeah. And he said unto his servant, Come and let us draw near to one of these places, and we will lodge in Gibeah, or in Ramah. So they passed on and went their way, and the sun went down upon them near to Gibeah, which belongeth to Benjamin. And they turned aside thither, to go in to lodge in Gibeah. And he went in, and sat him down in the street of the city, for there was no man that took them into his house to lodge. And behold, there came an old man from his work, out of the field at even. Now the man was of the hill country of Ephraim, and he sojourned in Gibeah. But the men of the place were Benjamites. And he lifted up his eyes, and saw the wayfaring man in the street of the city. And the old man said, Whither goest thou, and whence comest thou? And he said unto him, We are passing from Bethlehem, Judah, unto the farther side of the hill country of Ephraim. From thence am I, and I went to Bethlehem, Judah, and I am now going to the house of Jehovah, and there is no man that taketh me into his house. Yet there is both straw and provender for our asses, and there is bread and wine also for me, and for thy handmaid, and for the young man that is with thy servants. There is no want of anything. And the old man said, Peace be unto thee. Howsoever, let all thy wants lie upon me, only lodge not in the street. So he brought him into his house, and gave the asses fodder, and they washed their feet, and did eat and drink. As they were making their hearts merry, behold, the men of the city, certain base fellows, beset the house round about, beating at the door. And they spake to the master of the house, the old man, saying, Bring forth the man that came into thy house, that we may know him. And the man, the master of the house, went out unto them, and said unto them, Nay, my brethren, I pray you, do not so wickedly, seeing that this man is come into my house. Do not this folly. Behold, here is my daughter, a virgin, and his concubine. Them I will bring out now, and humble ye them, and do with them what seemeth good unto you. But unto this man do not any such folly. But the men would not hearken to him. So the man laid hold on his concubine, and brought her forth unto them. And they knew her, and abused her all the night until the morning. And when the day began to spring, they let her go. Then came the woman in the dawning of the day, and fell down at the door of the man's house, where her lord was, till it was light. And her lord rose up in the morning, and opened the doors of the house, and went out to go his way. And behold, the woman, his concubine, was fallen down at the door of the house, with her hands upon the threshold. And he said unto her, Up, and let us be going. But none answered. Then he took her upon the ass, and the man rose up, and gat him unto his place. And when he was come into his house, he took a knife, and laid hold on his concubine, and divided her, limb by limb, into 12 pieces, and sent her throughout all the borders of Israel. And it was so that all that saw it said, There was no such deed done nor seen from the day that the children of Israel came up out of the land of Egypt unto this day. Consider it, take counsel, and speak. End of chapter 19. Chapter 20. Then all the children of Israel went out, and the congregation was assembled as one man, from Dan even to Beersheba, with the land of Gilead unto Jehovah at Mizpah. And the chiefs of all the people, even of all the tribes of Israel, presented themselves in the assembly of the people of God, 400,000 footmen that drew sword. Now the children of Benjamin heard that the children of Israel were gone up to Mizpah. And the children of Israel said, Tell us, how was this wickedness brought to pass? And the Levite, the husband of the woman that was murdered, answered, and said, I came into Gibeah that belongeth to Benjamin, I and my concubine, to lodge. And the men of Gibeah rose against me, and beset the house round about me by night. Me they thought to have slain, and my concubine they forced, and she is dead. And I took my concubine, and cut her in pieces, and sent her throughout all the country of the inheritance of Israel, for they have committed lewdness and folly in Israel. Behold, ye children of Israel, all of you, give here your advice and counsel. And all the people arose as one man, saying, We will not any of us go to his tent, neither will we any of us turn unto his house. But now this is the thing which we will do to Gibeah. We will go up against it by lot, and we will take 10 men of 100 throughout all the tribes of Israel, and 100 of 1,000, and 1,000 out of 10,000, to fetch victuals for the people, that they may do when they come to Gibeah of Benjamin, according to all the folly that they have wrought in Israel. So all the men of Israel were gathered against the city, knit together as one man. And the tribes of Israel sent men through all the tribe of Benjamin, saying, What wickedness is this that is come to pass among you? Now therefore deliver up the men, the base fellows that are in Gibeah, that we may put them to death, and put away evil from Israel. But Benjamin would not hearken to the voice of their brethren, the children of Israel. And the children of Benjamin gathered themselves together out of the cities unto Gibeah, to go out to battle against the children of Israel. And the children of Benjamin were numbered on that day out of the cities 26,000 men that drew sword, besides the inhabitants of Gibeah, who were numbered 700 chosen men. Among all this people there were 700 chosen men left-handed. Every one could sling stones at a hairbreadth and not miss. And the men of Israel, besides Benjamin, were numbered 400,000 men that drew sword. All these were men of war. And the children of Israel arose and went up to Bethel, and asked counsel of God, and they said, Who shall go up for us first to battle against the children of Benjamin? And Jehovah said, Judah shall go up first. And the children of Israel rose up in the morning and encamped against Gibeah. And the men of Israel went out to battle against Benjamin. And the men of Israel set the battle in array against them at Gibeah. And the children of Benjamin came forth out of Gibeah, and destroyed down to the ground of the Israelites on that day 22,000 men. And the people, the men of Israel, encouraged themselves, and set the battle again in array in the place where they set themselves in array the first day. And the children of Israel went up and wept before Jehovah until even. And they asked of Jehovah, saying, Shall I again draw nigh to battle against the children of Benjamin my brother? And Jehovah said, Go up against him. And the children of Israel came near against the children of Benjamin the second day. And Benjamin went forth against them out of Gibeah the second day, and destroyed down to the ground of the children of Israel again 18,000 men. All these drew the sword. Then all the children of Israel and all the people went up, and came unto Bethel, and wept, and sat there before Jehovah, and fasted that day until even. And they offered burnt offerings and peace offerings before Jehovah. And the children of Israel asked of Jehovah, for the ark of the covenant of God was there in those days, and Phinehas the son of Eleazar, the son of Aaron, stood before it in those days, saying, Shall I yet again go out to battle against the children of Benjamin my brother, or shall I cease? And Jehovah said, Go up, for tomorrow I will deliver him into thy hand. And Israel set liers in wait against Gibeah round about. And the children of Israel went up against the children of Benjamin on the third day, and set themselves in array against Gibeah, as at other times. And the children of Benjamin went out against the people, and were drawn away from the city. And they began to smite and kill of the people, as at other times, in the highways, of which one goeth up to Bethel, and the other to Gibeah, in the field, about 30 men of Israel. And the children of Benjamin said, They are smitten down before us, as at the first. But the children of Israel said, Let us flee, and draw them away from the city unto the highways. And all the men of Israel rose up out of their place, and set themselves in array at Baal Tamar. And the liers in wait of Israel brake forth out of their place, even out of Merah Giba. And there came over against Gibeah 10,000 chosen men out of all Israel, and the battle was sore, but they knew not that evil was close upon them. And Jehovah smote Benjamin before Israel, and the children of Israel destroyed of Benjamin that day 25,100 men. All these drew the sword. So the children of Benjamin saw that they were smitten, for the men of Israel gave place to Benjamin, because they trusted unto the liers in wait, whom they had set against Gibeah. And the liers in wait hasted and rushed upon Gibeah. And the liers in wait drew themselves along, and smote all the city with the edge of the sword. Now the appointed sign between the men of Israel and the liers in wait was, that they should make a great cloud of smoke rise up out of the city. And the men of Israel turned in the battle, and Benjamin began to smite and kill of the men of Israel about 30 persons. For they said, Surely they are smitten down before us, as in the first battle. But when the cloud began to arise up out of the city in a pillar of smoke, the Benjamites looked behind them, and behold, the whole of the city went up in smoke to heaven. And the men of Israel turned, and the men of Benjamin were dismayed, for they saw that evil was come upon them. Therefore they turned their backs before the men of Israel unto the way of the wilderness. But the battle followed hard after them, and they that came out of the cities destroyed them in the midst thereof. They enclosed the Benjamites round about, and chased them, and trod them down at their resting place, as far as over against Gibeah toward the sun rising. And there fell of Benjamin 18,000 men. All these were men of valor. And they turned and fled toward the wilderness unto the rock of Rimmon. And they gleaned of them in the highways 5,000 men, and followed hard after them unto Gedom, and smote of them 2,000 men. So that all who fell that day of Benjamin were 25,000 men that drew the sword. All these were men of valor. But 600 men turned and fled toward the wilderness unto the rock of Rimmon, and abode in the rock of Rimmon 4 months. And the men of Israel turned again upon the children of Benjamin, and smote them with the edge of the sword, both the entire city, and the cattle, and all that they found. Moreover, all the cities which they found they set on fire. End of chapter 20. Chapter 21. Now the men of Israel had sworn in Mizpah, saying, There shall not any of us give his daughter unto Benjamin to wife. And the people came to Bethel, and sat there till even before God, and lifted up their voices, and wept sore. And they said, O Jehovah, the God of Israel, why is this come to pass in Israel, that there should be today one tribe lacking in Israel? And it came to pass on the morrow that the people rose early, and built there an altar, and offered burnt offerings and peace offerings. And the children of Israel said, Who is there among all the tribes of Israel that came not up in the assembly unto Jehovah? For they had made a great oath concerning him that came not up unto Jehovah to Mizpah, saying, He shall surely be put to death. And the children of Israel repented them for Benjamin their brother, and said, There is one tribe cut off from Israel this day. How shall we do for wives for them that remain, seeing we have sworn by Jehovah that we will not give them of our daughters to wives? And they said, What one is there of the tribes of Israel that came not up unto Jehovah to Mizpah? And behold, there came none to the camp from Jabesh-Gilead to the assembly. For when the people were numbered, behold, there were none of the inhabitants of Jabesh-Gilead there. And the congregation sent thither 12,000 men of the valiantest, and commanded them, saying, Go and smite the inhabitants of Jabesh-Gilead with the edge of the sword, with the women and the little ones. And this is the thing that ye shall do, ye shall utterly destroy every male and every woman that hath lain by man. And they found among the inhabitants of Jabesh-Gilead 400 young virgins that had not known man by lying with him, and they brought them unto the camp to Shiloh, which is in the land of Canaan. And the whole congregation sent and spake to the children of Benjamin that were in the rock of Rimmon, and proclaimed peace unto them. And Benjamin returned at that time, and they gave them the women whom they had saved alive of the women of Jabesh-Gilead, and yet so they sufficed them not. And the people repented them for Benjamin, because that Jehovah had made a breach in the tribes of Israel. Then the elders of the congregation said, How shall we do for wives for them that remain, seeing the women are destroyed out of Benjamin? And they said, There must be an inheritance for them that are escaped of Benjamin, that a tribe be not blotted out from Israel. Howbeit, we may not give them wives of our daughters, for the children of Israel had sworn, saying, Cursed be he that giveth a wife to Benjamin. And they said, Behold, there is a feast of Jehovah from year to year in Shiloh, which is on the north of Bethel, on the east side of the highway that goeth up from Bethel to Shechem, and on the south of Lebona. And they commanded the children of Benjamin, saying, Go and lie in wait in the vineyards, and see and behold, if the daughters of Shiloh come out to dance in the dances, then come ye out of the vineyards, and catch you every man his wife of the daughters of Shiloh, and go to the land of Benjamin. And it shall be, when their fathers or their brethren come to complain unto us, that we will say unto them, Grant them graciously unto us, because we took not for each man of them his wife in battle, neither did ye give them unto them, else would ye now be guilty. And the children of Benjamin did so, and took them wives, according to their number, of them that danced, whom they carried off, and they went and returned unto their inheritance, and built the cities, and dwelt in them. And the children of Israel departed thence at that time, every man to his tribe, and to his family, and they went out from thence every man to his inheritance. In those days there was no king in Israel. Every man did that which was right in his own eyes. End of chapter 21. And also the end of Judges, American Standard Version.